Hello everyone, welcome to my video. My name is Henry Rivaldo. Student ID number is 2018113911. Here, I will explain about recruitment modeling. Definition of recruitment modeling. What is recruitment modeling? Recruitment modeling is the initial first technical representation of the system. Python sentences of what are a good way to communicate, but are not always the best way to present requirement for computer software. Recruitment modeling use a combination of the text and diagrams to present requirements in a way that is relatively easy to understand and, more importantly, directly used to review a correctness, completeness, and consistency of requirements. The main aim of recruitment modeling is to support the end goal of software development. It also aims to achieve this objective, identify and establish the best practice required to create an effective model. Outline the way you intend to put said practice into action. System analysis based overview. System analysis is the process of studying a procedure or business to identify its goal and propose and create system and processes that will eventually achieve them. Another view sees system analysis as a problem-solving technique that breaks down a system into its component piece and how well does part work and interact to accomplish their purpose. The overall goal of the system analysis phase is to understand the purpose project, ensure that it will support business requirement and build a solid foundation for system development. System analysis active. There are several system analysis active, namely 1, recommend modeling, 2, data and process modeling, 3, object modeling, 4, development strategy, and 5, system requirement document. Team-oriented method and techniques. There are several team-oriented method and technique, namely 1, joint application development or GAD, 2, rapid application development or RAD, and 3, agile methods. Joint application development or GAD. Joint application development or GAD is a data collection technique that allow project team members, user, and management to work together to identify requirements for a system. GAD is claimed to be one of the most useful methods for gathering information from user and can reduce scope creep by up to 50%. This can prevent the system from being too specific or too abstract, both of which can cause problem for the effective takes of the SDLC. There are several advantages of joint application development. Namely, one, GAD allow you to resolve difficulties more simply and produce better error-free software. Two, the joint collaboration between the company and the client lower our risks. Three, GAD reduce costs and time needed for project development. Four, well-defined requirement improve system quality. Four, due to the close communication, progress is faster. Six, GAD encourages the team to push each other to work faster and deliver on time. There are several disadvantages of joint application development, namely, one, different options within the team make it difficult to achieve goal and maintain focus. Two, depending on the size of the project, GAD may require a significant time commitment. Rapid application development, or RAD. Rapid application development is a software development process based on prototyping without any specific planning. In RAD, there is less attention paid to the planning and more priority is given to the development tasks. It's target at developing software in a short span of time. There are several advantages of rapid application development, namely, one, if offer improve flexibility as developer can adapt to required change and incorporate new functionalities and feature during to build process. Two, you can create quick interaction that cut down time frame to make your delivery process a lot more streamlined. Three, it is dependent on customer collaboration, satisfying every stakeholder such as user, developer, and client. There are several disadvantages of rapid application development, namely, one, it requires hook collaboration and joint effort from many people and department. This can become confusing if it isn't organized or conducive the quality. Two, it can lead to problems such as code documentation issue if you have a large team that is mostly filled with new or inexperienced developer. Agile method. The Agile method is specific approach to project management used in software development. This method helps teams respond to software development uncertainties by using iterative increment, commonly known as sprints. There are several advantages of Agile methods, namely, one, the software development process requires relatively fast time and does not require large resources. Two, changes can be handled quickly according to client need. Three, clients can provide feedback to the development team in the program creation process. There are several disadvantages of ugly methods, namely, ugly methods is not sustainable if it is done by a team that is not commitment to accompanying the project together. Two, this ugly method is not appropriate when done with a large number of team. Three, the development team must always be prepared because things can occur at any time. Modeling tool and technique. Modeling help user, manager, and information technology to understand the design of the system. There are several tools and techniques in modeling. Number one, functional decomposition diagram or FDD. FDD represents the top-down of function process, and analysts can show a business function and simplify it down to a lower level of function or process. Number two, business process modeling or BPM. During system development, analysts often create model using a standard language called business process modeling notation or BPMN. Number three, data flow diagram or DFD. Analysts can create DFD to display the system's performance, process, and data transformation. Number four, unit modeling language or UML. UML is method for visualizing and documenting system software design. UML use object oriented design concepts with a variety of graphic tools. That's all from me. Thanks you for the watching and listening to my video. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.